minute conversation on what a geriatric doctor does and how can he help compared to a GP.
This has a subspecialty itself is like as in pediatrics is for young people, that is children and all. Geriatrics is for people above 60 years of age, and we know we have an aging population, and we want more and more specific care because the elderly age group needs specific care because they have their specific problems. And the way that is different is that a comprehensive geriatric assessment, which means to see in detail, matlab detail mein dekhna, and it involves, because an older person's health is not only about the physical symptoms, it's about memory, it's about presence, absence of depression, whether there is any urinary incontinence, whether there is any constipation, whether there is any fear of fall, what is their social circle, whether they have friends, they don't have friends, what is the situation at home, what is their financial situation, and ultimately a problem list is created, and which every problem is addressed very clearly, so that ultimately a long-term plan, as in a continuum of care, as we say, not only when you visit me, but at home, and ultimately, hopefully, you are able to be independent even in the community. So that is known as the concentration in geriatrics is about a continuum of care, and ultimately, the older person's quality of life. That is how independent you are. As Mr. Modi has been saying, Atmanirbhar. So for older people, how independent they are matters a lot, because the more independent they are, the more they are able to do things, and they are ultimately able to be contributing to society, contributing to self, and obviously trying to overall be an asset not only to themselves but to the society. So it's a holistic attitude to an older person.
Thank you, Doctor. Tare Soshi would like to invite Dr. Prem. I think, you know, we've had so many sessions here regarding, you know, how we're going to get out from this pandemic now that is seeming much more near term. So I think it's a good time to actually have the doctor tell us how do we safely now go out of the lockdown when we're close to that. Doctor, if you could continue.
Yeah, so I think most importantly is let us get some facts very, very clear. The lockdown it's known as a lockdown 5.0, or you can say an unlockdown which has started. COVID cases are still very much there. It's not finished. We are nowhere near the end of the pandemic. There are still cases very, very high. Every day we are falling short of beds. So these are the facts. So there is not a lot of things which have changed as far as medically is concerned. So we need to be very, very careful in our so-called strategy ki hum kya karne wale hain abhi aur hume kya karna chahiye. So the motto is lockdown might have gone, but COVID-19 is still here. So we can't just entirely relax. And this is what we need to do. It's still that health is most important. Prevention is better than cure. That is a motto which has always been the case. And even research shows that we don't really know when we will be able to tackle with COVID-19 entirely. India has a mixture of a population, but an older population is significantly high. And whoever has undergone the lockdown has taken all the precautions. But what we are liable to is that suddenly when the lockdown was lifted, I mean, when the lockdown was basically lifted, we clearly saw that there were a lot of people who wanted to go out. So we saw a lot of people in places like, I mean, the beaches and this and all. We even saw, even I have seen people without the masks also. So we have to be very, very, very careful. Nothing has really changed. You have to realize that there has also was an economic standstill. So that's why industries, offices, everything was slowly started. But the situation is very much the same. So ultimately, there are a lot of strategies. Jo nuske hain, jo cheeze hain, wo hame khud karni hai. We ourselves have to make sure that we continue to do so. So what are we going to do? The rules very much remain the same. We still have to wash our hands at all times. That is not going to change. These are going to be a part of our life now. They were already a part of our life before, but I am even saying even more so. Please keep cleaning our surroundings. We have to be extremely aware if there are any changes which are taking place in our body because of any illness. We have to have an exercise regimen, keep fit, eat properly. And also, there are other things which we sort of need to do to be very, very important. Now, let me just elaborate a bit. Elaborating will be in specific points. One is, of course, our hygiene. Please, our hygiene is not going to change. We have to sort of remember that is not going to change. We actually have to open up every area of our house, keep the windows open, try to have some fresh air. Of course, now we have to also see, unfortunately, I mean, even the rainy season will be coming. So we have to look after those things also, like even cold and cough in general will sort of increase. Try to clean every point which we use very frequently, that is the washrooms, the tabletops, our home. Then it's better to use, I mean, we can also use liquid soaps. Have hand sanitizers, but they need not be necessarily be there at home. Of course, in your buildings at various places, they should be there. The reason when you enter, maybe in the lifts, in the cars. Why? Because whenever you're home, it's better to use soaps, because if you do proper hand wash with around 20 to 30 seconds, it is very, very good, and it actually keeps the virus at bay. We actually have to try to keep maximum amount of reorganize the furniture, try to have in common areas at home, try to maintain that physical distancing to the maximum possible. Then the dustbins which we have should always be covered. Absolute cleanliness should be there in all the kitchens. Then see, I mean, there is no hoarding to be done. Just see that you have adequate amount of stock of maybe tissues, disinfectants, your floor cleaners, your soap, your mask, gloves, both at home as well as, and those people who actually go to the workplace. Your doormat should be cleaned. And when you lose the lifts, try to obviously be minimum amount of people, try to maintain 3 feet. Then routine cleaning, of course, of the lift, which through your society will be done. Same is with your area as well. Now, at some point in your house, somebody will be actually going to buy groceries. So aap khana, aap dal, chawal, wo sab lene zarur jayenge. So that is very important ki aap shopping karne bhi jayen, to usme bhi physical distancing aapko rakhna hai, and always try to keep a hand rub with you. Aur jab aap fruits and vegetables le lete hain, to wapas aake ek bucket of water mein usko fir acche se dhoiye 20 minute tak. क्लीन कीजिए, उसके बाद उसको यूज कीजिए, बिकॉज ये सब प्रिकॉशंस बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. फिर आप टेबल टॉप जहाँ पे ग्रॉसरी रखते हैं उसको भी अच्छे से आपको क्लीन करना है. फिर डिपेंड करता है कि घर पे कौन कौन है, कि अगर आप मे बी बुजुर्ग हैं एंड इफ यू आर ओनली टू पीपल देन ऑफकोर्स वी लव टू सी, बट एवरीबडी विल हैव टू टेक रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इन ट्राइंग टू क्लीनिंग द हाउस, चाहे वो डेस्क हो, table tops ho, toilets ho. Then there is a specific thing I want to say, where people are starting to go to work and they are coming back and having children and older people at home. Please make sure that you actually clean. When you return home, empty your pockets, remove your wristwatch, mobile phone, and spray them with the disinfectant, clean them thoroughly. Then try to also keep your footwear outside. As soon as you have come back, try to wash those clothes off. If you are not able to wash them immediately, try to put them in, soak them in soap water and then wash them later, because ultimately that is also very, very important, especially when you are going out. When you are going out, please try to wear masks at all times, and even in your workplace, whoever is going to the workplace, please try to wear masks at all times, and please try to keep all your meetings to video. Video mein hi baat karna acha hai, message mein baat karna acha. Phir haath dhona specifically aap already kar rahe honge, main sirf aapko baar baar bata raha hu kyunki ye abhi bhi same hi cheez hai. अनलॉकडाउन में भी ये बदलेगा नहीं, खाने के बाद, खाने के पहले, काम पे जाने के बाद, काम के जाने के बाद पहले खांसते हैं, छींकते हैं, तो मैंने जैसे पहले भी बोला हुआ है कभी भी हाथ में नहीं करना है, या तो हैंडकरचिफ में कीजिए या तो टिश्यू में कीजिए, टिश्यू करते तो उसको डिस्पोज कर दीजिए, हैंडकरचिफ है तो उसको धोइए, और उसको टॉयलेट यूज के बाद तो करेंगे, खांसते हैं छींकते हैं तो फिर हाथ में नहीं और बाहर ऐसे नहीं, अगर आपके पास टिश्यू या कुछ है नहीं तो फिर ऐसे करना है आपको और फिर उसको साफ करना है, कभी भी हवा में या ड्रॉपलेट्स जैसे नहीं जाने चाहिए। फिर मैंने जैसे बोला 20 से 30 सेकंड तक अच्छे से आपको वॉश करना है। फिर फेस मास्क की जो बात होती है, फेस मास्क हमेशा हम डालते तो हैं पर फेस मास्क कभी कभी हम गलत डाल देते हैं, तो टाइप ऑफ फेस मास्क जैसे आप क्लॉथ का डाल रहे हैं, कभी भी मास्क के फ्रंट को मत छूइए, उसके जो साइड में जो दिए हुए हैं उसका रीजन है, तो इसीलिए उसको ऐसे डाल के फिर कान में डाल लीजिए। उसके बाद एक और चीज मैंने देखा है, बहुत सारे लोग डालते तो है लेकिन नाक पे तो रहता ही नहीं है मास्क, तो वैसा नहीं करना, आपका माउथ एंड फेस पूरा पूरा जो है ना वो होना चाहिए, कुछ गैप नहीं होना चाहिए, सिर्फ यहाँ डाल के मुंह में डाल के मास्क डाल के कुछ फायदा नहीं। तो उसके बाद भी डेली वॉश आपको करना है मास्क को, अगर आप रीयूजेबल मास्क यूज कर रहे हैं, और अगर डिस्पोजेबल मास्क यूज कर रहे हैं तो फिर आपको प्लीज उसको अच्छे से सेपरेट डस्टबिन में डिस्पोज करना है, और अभी भी हैंड वॉश करना है, मास्क डालने के बाद भी हैंड वॉश करना है, कभी भी मास्क के फ्रंट के साइड को मत छूइए, ऑलवेज जो साइड से है दो जो उसके हाथ दिए हुए वैसे ही निकालना है, कभी भी फ्रंट को नहीं छूना है। फिर जैसे जैसे चीजें आगे बढ़ेंगी, बहुत सारे लोग को बाहर जाना भी पड़ सकता है, अभी कुछ भी शुरू नहीं हुआ है, चाहे रेस्टोरेंट बाहर, मैं तो ये सिर्फ बता रहा हूँ जहाँ बाहर के जो कंट्रीज हैं वहाँ पे थोड़ा लॉकडाउन अनलॉक हुआ है, तो जैसे कैफेटेरियाज में है, खाने में है, तो हर जगह सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग बहुत ही अच्छे से किया जा रहा है, वहाँ पे डिवाइडर्स प्लास्टिक शीट्स वैसे डाले जा रहे हैं, काम पे भी प्लास्टिक शीट्स डाले जा रहे हैं, और डिस्टेंस रखा जा रहा है ताकि, और वो मार्क भी किया जा रहा है, जैसे मॉल्स में भी हो हर जगह मार्क्ड है कि कितना दूर है कितना जाना है, फिर जहाँ पे आप बिल विल पे करते हैं, आजकल तो जो डिजिटल का जमाना है, अगर आप डिजिटल में फिट हो गए हैं तो अच्छी बात है, तो वहाँ पे भी एरियाज में आपको केयरफुल रहना है। फिर ग्रीटिंग जो है बाहर, ऑफकोर्स फैमिली गैदरिंग और वो तो अभी हमें अवॉइड ही करना है। वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट जो है, जो हम हमेशा से बात करते आ रहे हैं लॉकडाउन में भी उससे पहले भी, इज द इम्यूनिटी। अगर कोई भी इन्फेक्शियस डिजीज है, जैसे अगर टीबी भी हो, एचआईवी हो, डेंगू भी हो, आपका जो और कोविड भी हो, आपका जो इम्यून सिस्टम है, जो फाइटिंग सिस्टम है बॉडी का, वो सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट है, वो हमारा फर्स्ट डिफेंस रहता है। जब भी कुछ बाहर से चीज आती है तो मैं इतना बताता हूँ आपको कि हमारा बॉडी बहुत ट्राई करता है फाइट करने के लिए, ऐसा नहीं कि वो नहीं करता है, बहुत मेहनत करता है, बहुत बहुत फाइट करने की कोशिश करता है, और इसीलिए हमें हमारी इम्यूनिटी को अभी भी स्ट्रांग रखना है, इम्यूनिटी को वीक नहीं होने देना है। इसीलिए इसके लिए हमें क्या करेंगे, इम्यून सिस्टम को स्ट्रॉन्ग करने के बाद में मैं ये नहीं बोलूंगा कि हम अमर हो जाएंगे या इनविंसिबल हो जाएंगे, वी हैव टू प्रिपेयर आवरसेल्फ। डाइट बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, फिर अच्छे से जो क्लीन प्रैक्टिसेस मैंने बोला वो इम्पोर्टेंट है, समय पे खाना खाइए, समय पे अच्छे तरह से पानी पीजिए, और अपनी दवाइयाँ समय पे खाइए। क्या क्या आप कर सकते हैं इम्यूनिटी बढ़ाने के लिए, एक तो आप अच्छे से सोना चाहिए आपको, नींद बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है, फिर आपके जो वैक्सीनेशंस आपके डॉक्टर ने बोले होंगे, बुजुर्गों के लिए निमोनिया के रहते हैं, इन्फ्लुएंजा के लेते हैं, वो आपने पहले लिए हैं तो अच्छी बात है, नहीं तो सीजन जब चेंज होना है तो लेना चाहिए। फिर हेल्थी और बैलेंस डाइट खाना है, स्ट्रेस इंड्यूसिंग फैक्टर्स है उससे दूर रहना। मैं मानता हूँ ये लॉकडाउन से अनलॉक क्या होगा, ये होगा, वो सब सोच आपको नहीं सोचना है वो, क्योंकि जो आपके हाथ में वही कीजिए, ना गवर्नमेंट आपके हाथ में, ना एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव डिसीजन आपके हाथ में, so keep yourselves to things which you can do, not things that which are going to make you more and more tense. WhatsApp, social media, try to filter jo news hai usko hi grahan kijiye jo aapko help karega, aur health ke bare mein to please ask for healthcare professional, jaise maine pehle bhi bola hai, verify kijiye news uske baad hi, google doctor pe mat believe kijiye, self medicate please mat kijiye, फिर फिजिकली एक्टिव आपको रहना है, योगा प्रैक्टिस करना है, मेडिटेशन वो सब कीजिए। अभी ओपन हुआ है तो बुजुर्ग मैं अभी भी बोलूंगा, अगर आप स्टिल अपने फ्लोर पे ही चल सकते हैं तो अच्छा, नीचे ऐसे टाइम पे जाइए अगर जाना भी है तो, क्राउड जब कम है 65 के अबव मैं तो अभी भी बोलूंगा, अगर बहुत सारी डिजीजेज है तो आप अवॉइड कीजिए, घर पे चलना है चलिए। क्योंकि हो क्या रहा है कि बहुत सारे लोग सडनली, जो बोलते हैं ना कि प्रेशर अभी निकल गया है, तो फिर बहुत सारे लोग सडनली मतलब सब बाहर आ गए हैं, और मैंने यही देखा है कि बहुत सारे लोग मास्क भी नहीं डाल रहे, तो मास्क बिल्कुल डालना है लोगों को। तो थोड़ा और सोशल फिजिकल डिस्टेंसिंग मेंटेन करके ही आपको चलना है। फिर आपका जो ब्लड प्रेशर है और जो शुगर है, अगर आपको है तो उसको आप प्लीज कंट्रोल में रखिए, चेक करते रहिए अपने डॉक्टर के क्या कहते हैं, आप अपने डॉक्टर के कांटेक्ट में रहिए और उनसे भी बात करते रहिए कि आपको क्या प्रिकॉशंस लेने हैं। जहाँ तक अस्पताल का सवाल है, अगर आपको बेसिक हेल्थ चेकअप करना है तो अभी भी आपको जाने की जरूरत नहीं है, अनटिल एंड अनलेस आपको कुछ इमरजेंसी हो, कुछ सिम्टम हो, तभी आप हॉस्पिटल की तरफ जाइए। अगर आपका रेगुलर टेस्टिंग होने वाला है तो फिर अगर वो इमरजेंसी नहीं है तो उसको आप थोड़ा और टाइम आगे कर सकते हैं। अगर आप डायबिटिक हैं और शुगर देखते हैं तो आप शुगर घर पे भी देख के डॉक्टर से टच में रह सकते हैं। ये बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट टाइम है जब आप वीडियो कंसल्टेशन अपने सब डॉक्टर, सब हॉस्पिटल, सब ऑफर कर रहे हैं, मैं भी करता हूँ, तो वीडियो पे ही आप अपने डाउट्स क्लियर कर सकते हैं, फोन कॉल पे भी आप अपने डाउट्स क्लियर कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि टेक्नोलॉजी इतना एडवांस हो चुका है। मैं बॉटम लाइन यही है, मैं आपको बोलना ये चाहता हूँ कि अभी एक हफ्ते से हुआ है और ये जून 30 तक बोला गया है कि ये शायद अनलॉकिंग धीरे धीरे से शुरू होगा। इतना याद रखिए, कॉशियस अभी भी हमें रहना है। एक हफ्ते में ऐसा कुछ बदला नहीं है, केसेस अभी भी हैं, कोविड अभी भी है। हाँ, मैं मानता हूँ शायद हमें कोविड के साथ आगे जीना है और उसके बारे में हमें सोचना होगा, पर उसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि हम सब प्रिकॉशंस छोड़ दें, हम सब चीजें छोड़ दें। फिर थोड़े थोड़े इम्पोर्टेंट चीजें हैं जो जो बहुत महत्वपूर्ण रखती हैं, बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट हैं, वो हैं जैसे आपका हेल्थ। अभी भी सोसाइटीज हैं या बिल्डिंग्स हैं, मैं तो इतना ही बोल सकता हूँ कि जो इंडिविजुअल सोसाइटी, इंडिविजुअल बिल्डिंग है, उनका डिसीजन है कि अभी वो मेड्स को या दूसरे लोगों को अलाउ करेंगे नहीं करेंगे आपके हेल्प के लिए। क्यों बोल रहा हूँ, क्योंकि सब स्कैनिंग की बात है। थोड़े सोसाइटीज देखते हैं कि कौन से एरिया से वो आ रहे हैं, वहां पे क्या कंटेनमेंट जोन है, क्या वो सब चीजें क्लियर होने के बाद ही लोग मेड्स को अलाउ कर रहे हैं, और बहुत सारे सोसाइटीज तो अलाउ भी नहीं कर रहे फिलहाल, क्योंकि क्या है, टेस्टिंग सबका नहीं हो सकता है। तो ये चीजें जो है ये अभी भी क्लियर नहीं है, ये वो जैसे बोलते हैं ये सब इवॉल्विंग है। तो हमें हमें हमेशा मन में रखना चाहिए कि एवरी डे एट वन डे एट अ टाइम हमें आगे लेना है, एंड देन वी नीड टू गो फॉरवर्ड। बट प्लीज, इफ यू डोंट नीड टू गेट आउट, प्लीज स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ, ट्राई टू डू मोस्ट मीटिंग थ्रू वीडियोज, ट्राई टू कीप इन टच विथ योर नियर एंड डियर। आई नो नाउ यू माइट बी, वो डाउट जरूर रहेगा कि क्या हमारे जो बुजुर्ग है उनको जाके हम मिल सकते हैं क्या। नहीं, मैं बोलूंगा अभी भी थोड़ा रुकिए, क्योंकि अभी एक हफ्ता भी हुआ नहीं है, हमें देखना है कि केसेस कैसे हैं, कैसा बेटर है, और उस हिसाब से प्रिकॉशन लेते हुए आगे चलना है। थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर ऑल योर पेशेंट हियरिंग, आई कैन बी टेकिंग क्वेश्चन विद हिम।
डॉक्टर प्रेम, इन केस आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू टू अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ। डॉक्टर, यू डिड कवर क्वाइट अ फ्यू थिंग्स दैट यू नो आई डोंट नो वेरी वेल, बट वन ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट यू कुड कवर इज इज ऑन व्हाट इज अ गुड मास्क, व्हाट इज अ गुड कंफर्टेबल मास्क। आई थिंक द सर्जिकल मास्क दैट यू गेट फॉर 20 रुपीस वेरी अनकंफर्टेबल, द डिस्पोजेबल मास्क आर क्लॉथ मास्क गुड,
जी। एज फार एज मास्क का कंसर्न, वन थिंग इज देयर कि एक चीज तो बहुत ही है कि आप जब बाहर जा रहे हैं तो जरूर मास्क पहनना है, और घर पे अगर किसी को सिम्टम्स है और ये है तो उनसे भी फिजिकल डिस्टेंसिंग रखना है, आपको मास्क जरूर पहनना है। या आप ससेप्टेबल हैं, आपको ऑलरेडी लंग के डिजीजेस है या आपको कुछ इन्फेक्शन हुआ है, आपको लग रहा है, तो आपको मास्क पहनना है। मतलब टाइप ऑफ मास्क, बहुत ही डिपेंडेंट है कि आप कहाँ कर रहे हैं, क्या काम कर रहे हैं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द थ्री थ्री प्लाई मास्क जो बोलते हैं यूजुअल है, वो अनकंफर्टेबल होगा लेकिन वो काफी सेफ है. पर वो लोग पहन कब रहे हैं, ट्रैवलिंग के टाइम आप जा रहे हैं तब पहनना है. क्लॉथ मास्क भी काफी सेफ है, बट क्लॉथ मास्क का क्या है कि वो प्रोटेक्टिव, सेल्फ प्रोटेक्टिव है उस एरिया में जब आपको ज्यादा चांस नहीं है कि कुछ इन्फेक्शन हो सकता है. आप अगर ऑफकोर्स मैट हॉस्पिटल जो अप स्केल मास्क है, जो रियली जैसे N95 की बात होती है, वो नहीं जरूरत है कॉमन पर्सन के लिए. अंटिल अनलेस आपको पक्का पता है कि किसी को इन्फेक्शन है, किसी को सिम्टम्स है, उनको देना पड़ेगा और आपको देना पड़ेगा, नहीं तो N95 की जरूरत नहीं है. क्यों बोल रहा हूँ, क्योंकि N95 इज रियली नीडेड फॉर पीपल हु आर वर्किंग इन कोविड एरिया, फॉर हेल्थ केयर प्रोफेशनल्स, फॉर पीपल हु आर गोइंग टू गेट एक्सपोज, हु नो दैट दे आर कोविड पॉजिटिव पीपल, उन लोगों के लिए N95 की जरूरत है. तो मैक्सिमम देखा जाए तो क्लॉथ मास्क ठीक है, पर थ्री प्लाई मास्क जो लोग बोलते हैं अनकंफर्टेबल लग रहा है, वो काफी प्रोटेक्टिव है. पर आप क्या कर रहे हैं उस पर, अगर आप सिर्फ नीचे जाके कुछ लेके आने वाले हैं तो उसमें क्लॉथ मास्क भी ठीक है. पर याद रखिए, क्लॉथ मास्क हैज टू बी वॉश डेली. वॉट इज इम्पोर्टेंट इज समटाइम्स कंफ्यूजन लोगों को होता है कि थ्री प्लाई मास्क को रीवॉश कर सकते हैं. नहीं, जो डिस्पोजेबल वाले हैं उनको आपको फेंक देना है, बिकॉज वंस यू रीवॉश वो मास्क का जो इफेक्टिविटी रहता है वो ही खराब हो जाता है और खत्म हो जाता है. सो दैट इज समथिंग यू शुड नॉट डू. बट क्लॉथ वाले डेफिनेटली यू कैन. आप कहाँ हैं, कौन से एक्सपोजर में हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल आप पूरे दिन अभी भी स्टे होम स्टे थे और बाहर नहीं जा रहे, तो क्लॉथ मास्क भी चलेगा. पर अगर आप फॉर एग्जांपल स्पेसिफिकली जाने वाले हैं कोई एरिया में जो आपको लगता है शॉपिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स में, जहाँ पे आप ऑब्वियसली यू नो दैट देयर इज गोइंग टू बी मोर पीपल, फिजिकल डिस्टेंसिंग हैज टू बी प्रैक्टिस्ड. आई मीन वॉट एवर सेड एंड डन, स्टडीज क्या बोल रहे हैं कि फिजिकल डिस्टेंसिंग, हैंड हाइजीन एंड मास्क, ये तीनों लगाने पे काफी स्प्रेड का जो चांस है वो कम हो जाता है. अनदर थिंग इज मास्क जो है, अगर थोड़ा भी डैमेज हो गया है तो प्लीज डोंट थिंक कि नहीं उस पर हमने टेप लगा दिया या वो यूज हो सकता है. नो, वंस द मास्क इज डैमेज इट्स यूजलेस, सो यू हैव टू जस्ट थ्रो इट एंड यूज अनदर वन, बिकॉज इट डजेंट वर्क. बहुत सारे टाइम में वो हम ये काम चलाओ, नथिंग इज गोइंग टू बी काम चलाओ, नो जुगाड़ हियर, वी आर थिंकिंग अबाउट एब्सोल्यूट हेल्थ हियर. तो जो मास्क है वो ही मास्क पहनिए जो सिक्योर है कम्प्लीटली. डू नॉट ट्राई टू वेयर मास्क विच आर जस्ट गोइंग टू बी. अनदर थिंग इज कभी क्या होता है कि एक एक पूरा ऊपर टूट जाता है और हम थोड़ा लूज हो जाता है, दैट इज ऑल यूजलेस. क्योंकि क्या है, वो थोड़ा सा भी नीचे आ गया तो कोई यूज नहीं है उस मास्क पहन के. और वापस मैं बोलना चाहूंगा, नेवर टच द फ्रंट ऑफ द मास्क, बिकॉज दैट इज ऑलवेज, जो फ्रंट ऑफ द मास्क रहता है वो पूरा एनवायरमेंट को एक्सपोज. मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा हूँ वो कोविड ही है, बट इट इज एक्सपोज टू द एनवायरमेंट एंड इट शुड नॉट बी सॉर्ट ऑफ यूज्ड अगेन.
I have a question. I've been going down for a walk in the society compound for about 40 to 45 minutes daily. Of course, there are not many people, implemented social distance. But I find that wearing the mask continuously, you know, is a little suffocating.
Okay.
Because you are breathing out and then breathing in the same carbon dioxide. So since I'm suggesting we wear the mask all the time, I find it little difficult. So after every 5 minutes, I'm putting it down below my nose to breathe in fresh air and then putting it up. So is that okay?
To be very frank, if you pull it up, it's not much of use. And you don't have to worry about the fact that, because even the World Health Organization is very clearly saying that it's not that you're going to ultimately end up retaining that carbon dioxide and that is going to make you more sick. So no, that is not going to happen. So you don't need to worry about that. I know it is uncomfortable. There is no doubt about it. We are not people who are used to masks. I mean, I can say I am used to masks to an extent because I work in a hospital. But no common person is ever going to get used to masks. But we have to understand that this is the new normal. So we have to sort of adapt to it. We have to sort of adjust to it. And the fact that you are still trying to go down is good. please make sure that you maintain physical distancing, which you said you are doing. And if there are not a lot of people doing walking at the time, that is okay. But please maintain your distances. Again, what I am trying to tell again you is a little bit of discomfort is okay, but continue to wear it. Of course, if you just see nobody and you just take a moment, take the mask out and then put it again, that is okay. But to again removing it and taking it up is not really, it's not going to help you much. And secondly, we have to remember one thing, whenever we see familiar faces also, we are not going to sit down and start chatting and no, that's not, that's that we are not yet reached that. We can maintain that physical distancing and we can maybe say a hi, we can exchange pleasantries, but we are not still in the fact that we can actually sit down and chat and for a long time, because we are, see, whatever sudden then you also are coming out of a cocoon. You are at home only. And you, we all, most of the people were at home only, who were going quite less frequently. So we also need to be more and more careful. That's why I said work on building the immunity and keep your hand wash going. And when you go out, try to wear the mask at all times. If you take a break in between, that is not much of a harm. But if you keep removing it, that doesn't really help.
Hello, doctor. This is regarding the mask. Now, if we in our home, we are two elders.
Yeah.
One with an oxygen problem, another with a bronchiectasis. So the person with bronchiectasis always has his lower lungs full of
yeah.
and bacteria and all that sort of thing. And we have a young person who goes out. Now the problem is with me, if I have got autoimmune problem, that anybody even sneezes or coughs in the house or not, I immediately catch on the cold, even otherwise other than corona.
Mm-hmm.
So now, now it's very difficult for us, three of us, to live in a small segment to bedroom, but still we come in the kitchen and all. So we try to maintain the distance. So when we try to wear the mask at home, like you know, is it okay? Like the other lady was saying, you know, okay, pull the mask down just to breathe in because of the carbon dioxide. Now with me, I have dryness of the mouth and dryness of the mucus and all that. So I have to be very careful. So I find it very difficult. I try to remain in the bedroom.
Can't really take care of what other people are doing. What we need to do is what we can do. So in this case, I wouldn't advise you to take the shoes inside and wash it. I would say that it's best to keep the shoes outside. I mean, outside your house, just outside your house. Because I mean, if you're taking it inside, you're actually taking it in, from an outside environment in inside and then washing it. I mean, so it's always better that for going out, you keep separate slippers. And try to wear those slippers every time you go. Because you're going to wash your legs every time you come anyway. I would advise whenever you go to come back after errands also, try to, it's always best to take a complete bath. Or I'm not saying that you end up taking, I mean, because if you have to go frequently again and again, then you might have to take bath twice or thrice. And so be it. Because hygiene, personal hygiene, hand hygiene and all is very important. And if there is a person who is going to work, then I would say that they have to sort of maintain that social distancing, physical distancing at home also. Try to make sure that all their clothes and all are sort of washed immediately, or try to put in the antiseptic liquid, everything immediately, and then they should be washed. Ideally, they should be washed separately and not mixed with the clothes, mix with your clothes because they are outside. And then, of course, you can sort of desanitize whatever it is, whether it's a washing machine or whether it's a bucket, that you can do with antiseptic liquid. That is not much of an issue. And try to maintain that minimum physical distancing at home also. If the person is actually going out and coming in again and again, purely because you are dealing with two people, as you said, who already have lung diseases and to an extent have a bit of immunosuppression because of your particular autoimmune disease as well. So you need to be careful. I would say be careful, but not paranoid. Don't worry about, we can't worry about what is happening on the street because that's not in your control. But whenever we go out, try to make sure that you actually you are very careful, and whoever goes out should wear the mask after running the errands. Of course, as I told, all those vegetables should be put in a bucket, cleaned, and then they should be sort of utilized. All those things you have to do. And let me be frank, this is not something you never used to do. Everybody has been washing vegetables after coming back. It's not that we never used to wash. Nobody eats vegetables directly anyway, whether it's pre-corona or post-corona or in light years ago. Everybody has been doing the same thing. It's just coming to light because it's important and it helps in spreading the fomites. So that's why I would say, and frequent, and if you place, and whoever goes out, I would say that it will be best that he or she takes a small hand rub also with them, wherein they can keep sort of, whenever they touch something, after that they can use that. Before coming into home, they can use that. And of course, directly after they have kept whatever it is, they can go have a bath and then tackle other things.
Have to take the lift and they walk up. Now, keeping the sandals outside, it would be okay if you were on the top floor. Now, we do not know, when they walk up, they are taking their mask. Now, what may be positive on the sandal, and again, the person has to wear it throughout. Only from that point of view. Otherwise, what we could do is, we could take a plastic bag, keep it out, and put the sandals in the plastic.
Exactly. No, or you can keep it in one of the bags outside only, and then only use it when you need. Or what you have to do when you come in that particular time, you just have to put a desanitizing spray outside, especially on the soles.
Okay, yeah.
That is something you can do.
Yes, can I ask one question to the doctor about washing of the vegetables and all? No, because the problem is, yeah, we do wash vegetables in water, but then they say you have to use baking soda, or some people, run warm water, or they put salt, or they put vinegar. So what is the best method, doctor, to release this virus from the vegetables in the dog? And even especially for garlics and onions and all that, what to do,
I know. I mean, to be very frank, if it has to enter, it will enter. But because we can't overthink it. But yeah, baking soda is supposed to be pretty good, and lot of people are saying. But yeah, vinegar, I absolutely don't know because I haven't really encountered that. But baking soda, I know, and of course, people have been using pure water, maybe a bit of warm water. Yes. Again, there is no research which says that warmness or heat actually kills the virus or anything, nothing like that. But we need to do routine things of cleaning, which we always used to do, to make sure that we are not, this is basically to wash it away. That's why we are not telling you to put any antiseptics. We can't, because we are eating that. So, we are going to eat all that. We can't put antiseptic solutions in that, and we are actually going to make it inedible. So, yeah, sodium, as you said, baking soda there is research which says that baking soda is good. But a lot of most people are cleaning it with water, thoroughly keeping it first in water and then cleaning it again. And then that's how they're doing it. As far as your garlic and onion is concerned, of course, we try to dry it immediately, purely because these are things which get very much spoiled once you put too much of water. So yeah, that should be very standard. Yeah.
And for how long, haven't we to cut onions and garlic, maybe for a day or two, keep them out?
Because you can't even do that day. And for example, in monsoon season, how are you going to keep it out? It will get more spoiled. No, there is nothing that specifically says that you can touch after 1 day, 2 day or 3 day. You just have to make sure they are clean, and then you can sort of start using it. Again, I'm saying is, it's not touching that matters. Even after you touch that, you wash your hands, you're still safe. Touching that, not washing your hands, touching your face, touching your nose, those are the problems. It's not that, and it's fomites. So nothing is going to fly off or come in the air direct from the vegetable. You have to make sure that you keep that hand hygiene and stop touching your face, mouth and this. Then you are safe anyway. You have to make sure not only that you clean, after you touch that, you clean yourself. That is, I think, most paramount. The hand hygiene that you have to follow is very important. Yeah, so Mr. Saleh had actually focused on four things. One is, of course, family members. Three is maids. Two is all these food deliveries. And first, of course, is Amazon and Flipkart. Now, what I would say is, see, Amazon, I mean, if I have to start from the family members, I think family members can still wait. To be very frank, it's just been a week. It's just been a week since we have unlocked and we are seeing more rise in cases. So we have to, I mean, we have already waited for almost 2 months. We can wait for some more time, be a bit more safe. And then I'm purely saying it because nobody wants to regret the fact that we went. I'm not saying anything is going to happen. But nobody wants to redirect the fact, oh no, I visited and then they got sick. Even if they don't get COVID, they just get a normal cough or something, you are going to be tensed about it. So you can still maintain your not social isolation. Try to be in touch with video. That should be good enough for now. Keep helping them with groceries. Keep exchanging things. That is all fine. That is not much of an issue. Then even if you want to meet them, I would say not in the house. I mean, it will be minimal. You go down, maintain that physical distancing, just say hi and come back. But that is where I have a problem, because if you think, no, I want to go and still meet them inside, that is not something you should still do. So I would refrain from that. Three, as far as maids is concerned, let me tell you, it is very, very individual as of now. I said the societies are taking care of it. Like in the society I live, the maids are still not allowed. Everybody has particular guidelines. Even in today, it's come in the newspapers. The maids are saying that we want all the owners to get tested for COVID. Then only we'll come. I mean, they have the right. Let me be frank. They can also say that, why should we go in an environment where we don't know they have COVID or not? So it's a very controversial thing. And I don't think testing does not happen randomly if you're asymptomatic now, according to BMC. So that is going to be quite an impose. So reports also say that we might have to refrain from maids at least for another 5 to 6 months also. We don't really know, because one is from where they are coming, whoever they meet. Are they going to be having that social distancing? I am physical distancing. I'll give you an example. If there are 5 people living in a small 500 square feet, what kind of physical distancing are you expecting from them? So if we actually keep them and try to maintain what we are doing still, maybe we'll have to continue it for some time. And the societies and the individual buildings, they have to sort of take decisions on that. Whether it's just about hand rub, it's not only about just them using those basic sort of precautions and then sort of cooking. See, cooking, as you all know, more than me, involves a lot of touching to a lot of things. It's not just your, whether it's a cook, whether it's cleaning, even that happens. So even if with hygiene, everybody is going to be suspect as well. Then, so I think it can wait a bit, but again, it's an individual society. Individual society will have to sort of decide. Then as far as Zomato is concerned, then even Amazon, Flipkart have been saying that, yeah, they are using all the precautions that they do, and they must be also. Let me be very frank. These are all very professional organizations who are making sure that we get the stuff. But again, remember food. Food is always healthy as when you make it on your own. I mean, you all people know more than me that when you make it fresh, when you make it cooked, and when you know what you're eating, what circumstances it's made, you are always going to be mentally more at ease rather than thinking that, okay, now what happened there? How they would have cooked, whether the cook was wearing mask, this and all. So you can't keep thinking about that. So again, if you're not convinced about it, please don't order it. If you're going to order it, I would still say the outer surfaces of the boxes, they can be cleaned with your hand rub. take a tissue, clean the outer surface entirely, and then you can obviously open and try to eat it. Then Amazon and Flipkart boxes, I would say only they are always packed well. Make sure that the dabbas are something which you, if you don't really need it, discard it immediately. And whatever material you have, you take it, you can also sanitize it. Use, whenever you're trying to receive them, use gloves. Remember, after that, dispose the gloves off. Gloves are always not good in a way because they give you a false sense of security. वो हमेशा हमको लगाते कि हम सेफ है. नहीं, आप उसी ग्लव से 10 चीजें और छुएंगे तो आप इधर से उधर सब स्प्रेड कर रहे हैं. तो आपका अगर काम हो चुका है तो ग्लव्स निकाल के डिस्पोज कर दीजिए, हैंड रब कीजिए, और फिर डब्बा को खोलने के बाद फिर वो डब्बा आपका जरूरत नहीं है तो उसको डिस्पोज कर दीजिए, बिकॉज दैट इज द इजिएस्ट वे ऑफ टेकिंग आउट दैट फोमाइट फ्रॉम आवर आउटसाइड. So it's a bit of trusting Amazon and Flipkart, but at the same time, I would say if you are more convinced about getting things personally through the grocery, through this, then please do that. All these things can wait, but if you are going to accept such parcels, please be very, very vigilant as far as cleaning them concerned. And cleaning can be done. The surfaces can be cleaned through the disinfectants, your hand rubs, your hand washes, take a tissue, clean it up, and then only accept. If you're not going to wear gloves and you use hand rub immediately, it's okay. After you open, but you have to do the hand rub part because ultimately when if you're doing that, then it's okay. It's not a problem. But try to dispose of the boxes outside itself.
Immediately we keep it near the door, only need ice over there.
Yeah.
Because everything without holding hand, my daughter may open the door and all that. I go and I wash it with the soap.
That is something you have to be careful. I'm saying at home specifically, it's not necessary that you use the hand rub also, because hand washes are very safe. Hand rubs are something which we advocate when you go out because you might not get a water source. So immediately you need to you can't wait till home because you must have spread. I mean, I'm not even saying corona. You must have spread dirt here and there, touching here and there, even anyway. So, yeah.
If we need to consult you formally, even teleconsulting, I know you're a gestalt, and none of us, I don't think, I know how many of us live here just so. How do we take an appointment? How do we consult you?
Yeah, of course, if you need to consult me, yeah, you can directly tell me. I'm actually doing it through Zoom. My phone number can be provided. I mean, I can provide it, or Saleh can also provide you with that, and also through the JustLok website as well. So if you want to go through that, and then there is also through apps such as Clinic Advantage and Clinic Jet. So these are the ways I am sort of trying to get alone. But if you directly contact me, I'll be able to arrange whatever consultation you actually want, and we usually do it depending upon your convenience and my convenience. So that's how it can be done, and you can reach out to me. There is no issues with that. I'm always available. And secondly, of course, if you want to look at things which I'm doing online, that there is something known as The Geriatrician, which is a Facebook page. So that is something I keep updating things about elder care. And also there is something known as gracefulliving.co.in, which is the website. And also Graceful Living Elder Care, which is again a page on Facebook. So these